Welcome to www.taxmarketingforyou.com. Today's topic, helping accounting clients and marketing. In today's cutthroat world, one can easily become blind to one's true intention of helping others. But in your position, you are among the elite, the top 1 percentile of the population when it comes to helping others. You help others significantly and importantly, and a lot more than others do. More than most people help others, and usually a lot more than those you help would help you in exchange. Helping others is one of those innate purposes of life, really. Some believe we exist for the very purpose of helping. Certainly everyone agrees that having helped is one of the best feelings ever. So why is help such a muddled and often upsetting subject then? Well, I'm not sure I have the answer to that, but personally I've noticed that it can be soul-destroying to anyone if his help is not accepted and somewhat appreciated, or if the helpful intention is not even seen for what it is. We've all had to experience being looked at as if we were a monster because our intention to help was misinterpreted for something else altogether. Also, people easily blame those who help them if anything goes wrong, and none of us is immune to experiencing an offer of help to signify something negative, a statement that we need help and thus are somehow unable to solve our own problems, and whatnot. Accounting practice. Help those who want to be helped. The goal of helping is not uniform in its strength from one person to another. Anyone setting up a business is usually a lot more intent on helping, and so it is usually his lot to become frustrated when he sees that someone would dearly need his help, but try as he might, he cannot get this person to realize it or accept help. This then can lead to quite a lot of upsets. It is dispiriting to see how someone's life is hampered by some problem and yet not be able to convince that person of this situation so they would allow you to help them overcome it. So is there any way to alleviate this frustrating state of affairs? Yes, there is. The solution is twofold. Firstly, acquire more knowledge on why people resist help in general and how you can overcome most of those barriers that currently act as dead ends for your attempts of helping others. And believe you me, this is a huge step which can greatly change the way you think about marketing your services and the results thereof. Secondly, once you know your way of approaching people is optimized to make them realize what you want them to understand, help only those who want to be helped. Not everyone wants to be helped. Oh, I know, that's one of those things nobody admits, but it's true nevertheless. Some people cannot overcome their distrust of help. Others simply cannot ever look into their own actions and decisions, thus only seeking for someone else to blame for every possible problem they have in their business activity. And who knows, there may even be a few who've already given up trying, and help for them means ending it all. You cannot help everyone, and you cannot help a person before he's ready to help himself. The good news is that 9 out of 10 people can be helped, if you know how to approach them. Of these, the majority may need some time to come to the realization, but at least 10% will already be at that point where help is definitely wanted, provided you present it correctly. Thank you for your tireless work to help others. It is greatly appreciated despite the meager acknowledgement, and your help is vitally important to the society also. Keep a positive mind and want to help. It is guaranteed to make you feel better about life, yourself, and your business, and it certainly produces better results for your business. For more information, go to www.taxmarketingforyou.com.